Hi, this is Russell Stanley from teachertrainingvideos.com. I've had loads of questions this week about, Russell, what can we do if we can't do a face-to-face class and we need to record our lesson or record the learning content? Well, the answer is you need to use a technology called screen capture technology. It's everywhere. People who are building online courses and blended learning courses are using it all the time. I'm a big user of it. I'm going to demonstrate one of the products. There are many, many products, and I'm going to show you how you can use it to record a PowerPoint or talk over pictures or talk over documents, etc. It really is a useful tool, and it's great if you can't come into the class to teach your students and you need to produce some learning input. Hope you like the video. As always, if you do, please like it, please share it with other teachers, please any comments or questions, leave them below. And if it is good and you really like it, then please join me on my YouTube channel. Let's get started. So let's imagine that I wanted to record this presentation as a PowerPoint slide and then send it to my students. How can I do that? What would be the easiest way? Well, what I can do is I can use what we call a screen capture or a screen casting technology. That is, I can mark the area of the object that I want to record, turn on screen capture and record my voice, and then go through the slides. So, for example, I'm going to use a technology that I really like called Snagit, but there are many of these technologies. People often say to me, oh, Russell, why do you talk about Snagit? Snagit isn't free. Yes, it isn't free, but I use these technologies so often that I like to use a really reliable one. And Snagit does a lot of things, including it lets me edit. I can also add my webcam. It's got really quick processor, so in terms of actually producing the video. And so I'd rather spend a little bit of money. I think this costs $30, the educational version. Once you pay for it, you've got it forever. But yes, there are lots of free tools. You can write screen capture technology or screen cast technology into Google. You'll find many of these tools. I've worked with Jing, I've worked with Screen Toaster, I've worked with Matchware, I've worked with Screencast-O-Matic. But after using many of these tools, I need something reliable and quick because I'm often producing videos. So I use Snagit. I click on video, I click on capture, and I just mark the area that I want to record. Now, you don't need to go full screen, because when you mark out this area and you play it back, there are so many pixels these days in an image that it will look fine when you play it back. Then I just click on this button here and start. So let's imagine I'm going to do the recording. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and today we're going to look at the topic of acquiring vocabulary when you're trying to learn a language. My name is Russell Stannard and I work for teachertrainingvideos.com. Now press on the pause button, then I'm going to click to the next slide. Okay, and just carry on. What we're going to do today is look at what we understand about how vocabulary is acquired. We're going to look at some of the approaches that I take to actually looking at actually studying vocabulary, and we're going to draw on some ideas from my own studies of Polish. Full stop, go to the next screen. Carry on. Richard Meyer, blah, 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 blah. All right, so I've done the video. Now, all finished. I click on stop and I can click on play. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. And today we're going to look at the topic of acquiring. Now, that's it. The video is now done and it's ready. And that is why I love Snagit, because it's so quick. So I'm going to click on file, save as. I'm going to save this onto my desktop and I'm going to call this test video record lesson, and then save that. And then what I'm going to do now is just show you what that would actually look like. So if we come back onto my desktop, there is the video, test video. Let's just click and watch it. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and today we're going to look at the topic of acquiring vocabulary. And you can see how good quality it is even at full screen. And now what I can do with that video is upload it. I could upload it onto EdMod, or I could upload it onto YouTube. I could upload it into my Google Drive. And then what I can do is share the link to the video, and then the students would be able to access it. Now, I tend to do two things, and I'm going to show you both. I tend to either upload the video to EdMod, and then my students log into EdMod and they can play the video, or I upload it onto my YouTube channel and then I share the link. So I'm going to show you both of those approaches now. So I've got the video here. Good morning. And I can actually edit that video a little bit. So for example, let's imagine I wanted to cut this last bit out. I can go to the end, go to where I want to cut it out from, and then notice that it now shows me cut, and I can actually cut that part of the video. So you can do a small amount of editing. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on share, and I'm going to actually upload this video to YouTube. So I'm going to click on send to YouTube. Now all you need to do is to link your YouTube account to your Snagit. And once you've done it once, then it will always work. I mean, and I just simply write in test video TTV1, and I always have to give a quick description, so I'm just going to write test, and then I'm going to just write, as you always have to give one tag, I'm going to set it as unlisted. That's the easiest one to do because it means that nobody can find the video on YouTube. It's not a searchable video, but if you have the link, you can share the link with the students. Now I click on upload, and then almost immediately that video will be uploaded, and it will then tell me that the video has been uploaded. There it is. I'm going to click on get link. Now that means I've now copied that link. Now what I could do now is send my students an email, or I could put the link up online and the students could click on the link and they would be able to actually access my video. Let me show you. So for example, I'm going to write an email. Dear students, here is the video. Remember, I clicked on the button that said copy link. So if I paste, that link is actually, at the moment, it's actually in my, what we call the clipboard, because it copied it for me, Russell. That's a simple way for me to actually upload a video and to share it with my students. Now that's one possibility. There are other possibilities. Let me show you how we could upload the video onto YouTube. Now another way would be to simply go onto your YouTube channel, go to one of your classes, so I'm in my EdMod training group here, and then I simply click on this button and say watch this video. For example, I click on this button here, attach file, and all I need to do now is to go to the desktop. Remember, I saved that video on my desktop. I've just got to simply find that video now. There it is. Click on that, click on open, and then wait for the video to load and then post it. So now again, I've got another way of sharing a video so that my students can actually access my lesson. Now, are there any other ways? Well, yes, in fact, there are many, many. I'm going to show you one other way. If you have a Google account, another thing you can do is just link your Google account. So let's just come back again to link your Google account, and you have something called your Google Drive. So if I click on share and come down to my Google Drive, send to Google Drive, you can also do it this way. So I'm just going to put here test video, okay, teacher training videos one. Now I don't need to select a folder. Automatically all of the videos will be added into a folder called TechSmith, which you will find on your Google Drive. Again, all you need to do is to add your Gmail account and then click on upload. Now the same thing's going to happen. That video is going to be uploaded, and I can see it being uploaded here. Once it's uploaded, get link, exactly the same. Now what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to paste that link into a browser so you can see that video. So if I open up a browser now, and now I'm going to paste in that link. So I'm going to click on paste, because remember we copied the link. And if we press enter, now a few times it does take a few seconds for this video. It doesn't quite process the video as quickly on your Google Drive as it does within YouTube. YouTube's very, very powerful, but I can see that it is actually ready. I can click on the button and then play the video. So it's that simple as another way of actually sharing the video. Now I want to come back to one other thing now. Now, I want to show you another idea that I often use when I'm working with Snagit, again, for making learning material to share with students. What I've got here is a series of pictures. If we just click through, we've got one here, and then we've got another one, and we've got another one, and we've got another one, etc. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up Snagit. I'm going to kind of mark an area. It's not going to be perfect, this, but this will work, and I do this technique quite a lot. And what I'm going to do is I'm literally going to talk through the pictures. Now, this could be a history lesson or a geography lesson, or it could be anything, architecture, where I want to talk through a series of pictures. So I'm going to start with this one and click on the button. So I'm going to talk about picture one. Now I'm going to talk about picture two. Now I'm going to talk about picture three. Now I'm going to talk about picture four. Now I'm going to talk about picture five. And again, once I finish, I just click on the stop button and that video is made. So I'm going to talk about picture one. Now I'm going to talk about picture two. Now I'm going to talk about picture three. And that is a really powerful way, again, of producing learning content that you may need to create with your students, just working through pictures. Now, the only trick to doing that, and I will point it out, is that you need all the pictures to be in the same folder. And that's the reason why you can click from one picture to the next, because they're all saved together in the one folder. Now, the next idea that I'm going to demo to you is the one that I'm most interested in. That's using screen capture to give feedback to our students. You'll see in a minute how powerful it is. It was the reason that I won my awards for the work I've done. And it really is a great way of giving feedback to students and building a relationship with them through teacher presence. Let me highlight now how this would work. So let's imagine that this is a student's work, okay? And I've noticed a few things in their work that I want to give them some feedback on. So I'm going to now open up Snagit and I'm going to mark the area on the screen that I want to talk about. I don't need to go full screen because I can always scroll through, and I'm just going to imagine now that I'm talking to this student. Let's imagine this student's name's Tom. Hi Tom, yeah, just want to give you some feedback on your work. First thing is, can you give a bit more of an explanation of what you mean by cognitive overload? And just make sure it's absolutely clear, cognitive overload, how that applies to both the visual as well as to the auditory channels, because I don't think you're making that point very clearly. So could you just go through that and just kind of just give a longer definition? Now again here, I'm not happy with your use of sensory memory. You're not really explaining what sensory memory is, how sensory memory is limited. So could you again add a little bit more on what the sensory memory is? Just coming down to here, I really like the way you introduce the link between the sensory memory and the working memory. But what I'd like you to do here is to make sure again that you distinguish between the two and contrast these two different types of memory. Blah, 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 blah. See, now I've got this video. Hi, Tom. Yeah, just want to give you some feedback on your work. First thing is, can you give a bit more of an explanation? Now, that, imagine sending that now as a video to your students to give them feedback on their work. Now, this is something I've been doing for many, many years. As I said, it was the kind of area that got me really interested in using screen capture technology. And this is absolutely brilliant in an online course, because often on online courses, you're not meeting your students. And so for you to send them a personalized video with their feedback, and you can see how quick it is to do that, that is a really effective way of giving feedback to students. Just a super quick piece of promotion from me. If you are interested in Snagit, then I do run some Snagit courses. You can see it advertised on the front page of teachertrainingvideos.com, or simply click on the Snagit section. Loads of free videos showing you how to use Snagit, and you can click here to get information about the course as well. Right, let's get back to the video. Okay, really hope that was useful. Hope you like my idea around feedback. There's lots of research around that idea around now as well, but I originally wrote about that way back in 2006. You can see how easy Snagit is to use. There's lots more videos on using Snagit. If you just come to my website and look at the top, you'll see all sorts of different technologies, including Snagit. If you like my work and you want to keep up with it, well then please follow me on my newsletter. That way you keep up date with all the latest posts and blog posts and webinars and online courses that I'm running and new videos. And then the other thing that you can do is to follow me on my YouTube channel. And that way, if you do that, then you'll get the latest videos that go up onto YouTube. Finally, if you want to contact me, perhaps invite me to do a workshop or a presentation at your institution or conference, or if you're looking for online training, if you want me to help you to use a certain tool or to learn to teach online, then I do run online courses as well. And at the moment, those are quite popular because people are really interested in teaching online. Then please contact me, and thank you very much.